फ्रॉम द लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज. दैट डेफिनेशन वी आर मेकिंग इन द इंडिया, बेसिकली वी आर मेकिंग अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ इंजीनियर हु कैन एक्सट्रैक्ट बेस्ट बेस्ट फ्रॉम द लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज. सो द पर्सन हु कैन यूज द रिसोर्सेज वेरी इफिशियंटली एंड गेट द मैक्सिमम आउटपुट, दैट पर्सन इज अ गुड इंजीनियर. सो दिस dividing the problem and the getting the inputs but with the some limitations are given, yes this is the problem but with this number of inputs or this constraint you have to follow, so at the end of this subject you are able to learn all these things. Now the third is able to apply linguistic theory. Now linguistic means what? Whatever the problem, computing model, whatever the computing model we have designed, can we convert that problem into the very linguistic theories with different languages? Yes. So these are the three basic object outcomes we are able to do. Now if you observe, there is a relation between the objective and the outcomes. Objective we are setting in the beginning of the subject or beginning of the thing. So these are my objective, this I want to achieve. And at the end of the learning, end of the task, you will come with the course outcome. Yes, this target we have set and this we are able to do. If your objective and the outcomes matches, if your objective and outcome matches, then you will say, yes, my learning is successful. My learning is fruitful. My learning is outcome based. What I am set my task and at the end, yes, I am able to do that. That time, if that matches 100%, yes, it's a very good learning. You concentrated 100%, your guide has guided you 100%. So these are called as a course objective, course outcome. So what do we learn from this course objective, course outcome? In your day-to-day life, before starting anything, you must set your objectives. In the beginning of your day, you will say, yes, today my objective are to do this, to do this, to do this. So in the morning, you will decide your objectives of the complete day. To achieve that objectives, you will start working throughout the day. So you will work on the day with the eye on the objectives. So your process is more specifically because already I am knowing my objective. So I will work according to my objective. And at the end of a day, in the evening, you will just observe, yes, this I have decided. And in this way, I have processed in my whole day. Whether I have achieved my objective, means I'm able to convert my objective into the outcomes, means whatever I decided, I will learn these things. And at the end, yes, I'm capable of doing that. So if that thing is matching, your whole day is successful, fruitful. Otherwise, you are going aimlessly. So as an engineer, you must set your objective first before doing anything. And you must define the course outcome. And the process, the activities should be based on the keeping your eye onto the objective. So this is what we learn as an engineer, by setting the objective and outcomes. Okay. So this is what NBA states. So again, we'll move to the word called as the NBA. So NBA is a body who started saying this before doing any task, set your objective, set your outcomes, and plan your theory accordingly. So now my content of the subjects units are based on the objective, based on the objective, and based on my outcomes. So my course contents, the first unit is called as a formal language theory and finite automata. Finite automata. So this is my first unit. The allocated hours are the 8 hours. But this is the first unit, from my experience, it requires minimum 15 to 16 hours to complete this unit. Now why? Because this unit is nothing but a complete syllabus. If you learn this unit very carefully by heart, then all the other units are completely based on the unit 1. If you are not able to answer the unit 1, you are not able to answer, you understand any other units. So first unit is very important. So basically, we'll more concentrate on the first unit in the initial stage. So as I said, it is industry allocated. It is only 8 hours for to complete this unit. But as my experience says, it takes 15 to 16 hours, means completely double hours to complete this unit. Because I'm more concentrating on understanding this unit, understanding each and every concept of this unit. If you are able to understand every concept of this unit, all other units are very easy. You will become the capable of learning the other units by yourself. My role will be get minimized. But if you are not able to understand the first unit, I have to take the more efforts to explain the next units. So what my target is, to teach your first unit is to make you more independent to learn the other parts, other units. Okay. So now as the unit one says, formal language theory. So as I said, the language is made up of the alphabets and the grammars. So any language, so here we are going to learn the basic or how the languages are made up of. Means if we are considering the broadly all the languages. So what is the root of that languages? That is called the formal language, normal language. So you can derive any other language from that. So the language theory, some part theory means what, alphabet means what, grammars means what, how to write the language, how to make the words from the alphabets, how to make the sentences from the alphabet, how to find the meaning from the sentence. So all this theory part is the formal language theory. Now second part is called as finite automata. Now this again, the word, new word, automata is get added into your dictionary. Now finite automata, finite word, as you're having your first year, more mathematics, M1, M2, M3, second year M3. So finite is what, which is having some end. So that is called as a finite. And the automata means the model of a machine. So initially, again, we have seen that computation model. So that model is nothing but, in a Greek word, Greek language, we are calling it as a automata. Okay. Somewhere they are used called as a, in some reference books, you will find the, it's a, alphabets are automata, T-A-N again. So it's a one and the same thing. Don't get confused with that. Automata and automata is one and the same thing. So automata is nothing but a model of a machine. Model of a machine which will end somewhere. Finite means what? A model of a machine which will end somewhere. Okay, it is not going to be infinite. It is going on, but still we are not getting the answer. That will not happen. So we'll try to make a model of a machine which will end with some output, which will end with some output. That is called as automata. Okay, so that is about the first unit called as the formal languages and languages and the finite automata. Okay. Now second unit is called as a regular expression. Regular expression. And in your, even in, when you are using the computers, you are already using this regular expression. How you are using this regular expression? Means if you want to search some file with the name, you are not remembering the exact name. You are knowing that yes, this name was starting with R, but what is the next alphabets, next part of that file name? You are not remembering. You are just remembering the initial thing R. So when you are searching with the your my computer, you click on the find. You are searching for that. So how you are searching it? You will write the R star. Okay, R star. If you are knowing the extension, yes, dot dog dot c something. If you are not knowing the extension, R star dot, if you are not knowing extension, if you want to say yes, anything, you will use again the star. So what this star is? The star is nothing but a, or R star dot star, file name starting with R, having any number of alphabets dot any extension. The way of writing this search, that part is called as a regular expression. Okay. So